Next story.
Footballmania.com. Quarterback curses the almighty after heartbreaking loss. I gave up women. I gave up drinking. This is bullshit. Jocko Pastorius.
4 to 5 minutes.
In a disturbing turn of events, the star quarterback of the Dodge City Grendels, known for their vocal expressions of gratitude to a high power after every victory, unleashed a tirade against God following a devastating loss that left fans in disbelief.
The Grendels, renowned for their pre-game prayers and post-game praises, faced a critical moment in a closely contested playoff contest. Trailing by 6 points, quarterback Deacon Black executed a daring pass that was caught at the 5-yard line by fleet-footed All-Pro receiver Cyric Lofton. However, the team's jubilation was short-lived as Lofton was brought down shy of the goal line, with the clock ticking down to zero.
Deacon, usually not one for theatrics, turned his eyes to the sky and unleashed a tirade that shook the city.
"What the hell, God?" he roared, fists clenched at the darkening sky. "I did everything you asked. Sacrificed nights out, women. For what? For this. Every Sunday, on my knees, begging for your blessing, and this is what you give me?"
Deacon's outburst reverberated through the stunned crowd. The Grendels, known for their almost evangelical devotion, had built their success on a foundation of divine intervention. Now, that very foundation has crumbled beneath the weight of a single missed touchdown.
The post-game interview was even more raw. Deacon, eyes blazing, tore into the assembled media. "Why, God, why?" he roared, his voice hoarse with an admixture of grief and rage. "I gave you everything. I gave up women. I gave up drinking. I gave up stinky cheese. This loss..." Black paused, seemingly at a loss for words. "This is bullshit."
His outburst, a stark contrast to the usual post-game platitudes, left fans and teammates and coaching staff bewildered, as the quarterback had been a vocal proponent of attributing their success to divine intervention throughout the season.
"It's quite a departure from their usual demeanor," remarked sport commentator Lisa Thompson. "The team has always been vocal about their faith and belief in God's providence. This loss seems to have shattered that narrative, at least for the quarterback."
Black's unrepentant belligerence post-game sparked a firestorm. Sports pundits dissected his words like biblical verses, debating the validity of faith in the face of defeat. Fans, their jerseys stained with tears of both joy and sorrow, wrestled with their own beliefs, questioning the divine calculus that had delivered such a gut-wrenching loss.
One fan leaving the grandstands commiserated with Black, "I've been rooting for the team for years, and I think the quarterback's frustration is understandable. When you consistently attribute victories to divine intervention, why is it not God's fault if you lose? The boys played their hearts out tonight. I can't blame them. Who's left? Maybe Deacon shouldn't have shouted at the sky. God could have killed us all like animals. But emotions run high in sports, and athletes are human too."
Bat Masterson, mayor of Dodge City, was disgusted. "It was just a stupid thing to do," he said, wringing his hands. "That woman in Florida cursed a god, and an innocent delivery driver was incinerated. Who in my town will now have to suffer for this millionaire athlete's truculence?"
The city's houses of worship felt the seismic shifts. Pastors fumbled for sermons, unsure how to address the quarterback's public rebellion. Some condemned his blasphemy, urging repentance. Others offered cautious empathy, acknowledging the human need for answers in the face of anguish and tragedy.
Reverend Michael Goodman, a prominent figure in the community, stated, "While we understand the emotions that come with a heartbreaking loss, it's important to remember the values we hold dear. Blaming God for a defeat is an unusual stance, and we hope the quarterback finds peace in the midst of disappointment."